Can you convince someone you know how to solve a puzzle without telling them the answer? Log into your bank account securely without providing your password? Or prove that you're dismantling your nuclear weapons without revealing any government secrets? It may seem crazy, but these things are not only possible, but actually quite easy. Enter Zero Knowledge Proofs. After years of searching, you have finally discovered the rare magenta magic flower, which gives anyone who drinks its tea the magical ability to understand quantum mechanics. Excited, you show it to your friend Anakin. However, Anakin is colorblind. He thinks you merely have a purple poison flower, which looks exactly the same except its color. You happen to have a purple poison flower with you, and you're about to show Anakin these are different, but you suddenly realize that Anakin is greedy. If he realizes which is which, he'll steal the magic flower from you and use it for himself. You must prove to him that these two flowers are different, without telling him which is which. This might seem impossible. However, there is a clever trick. What you do is give the two flowers to Anakin, then let him put them behind his back and possibly switch them. Then, he shows them to you again, and you tell him whether he switched the two flowers behind his back. If the two flowers are different colors, you can always answer correctly. Did I switch them? Did I switch them this time? What about now? But if they are the same, you would have to guess, and you'd only have a one-half chance of guessing right. Did I switch them? This time? This time. If Anakin does this 10 times and you get it right every time, you can be 99.9% certain that the flowers are actually different. However, he still has no idea which flower is the magic one, so you can rest assured that he won't risk stealing any of them for himself. In fact, this is an example of a zero-knowledge proof. It's a test between a prover and a verifier with three key properties. Completeness. An honest prover will always pass the test. If the two flowers are indeed different colors, you will answer correctly every time. Soundness. A malicious prover will fail the test with high probability. If the flowers are the same color, it is extremely unlikely you will answer correctly every single time. Zero knowledge. If the prover is honest, the verifier would not learn any new information from this protocol. Anakin still has no idea which flower is the magic one. You might have some questions. First, is this a proof if the soundness is just with some probability? What if the liar just gets lucky? Well, in real life, we can just set the threshold to be really, really high, so it's extremely unlikely for liars to pass the test. If the probability of a liar getting lucky is smaller than you getting struck by lightning right now, it's probably not worth worrying about. Second, this protocol is cool and all, but it requires a lot of back and forth interaction between the prover and verifier. Wouldn't that require a lot of computation and network traffic, making it really inefficient? Well, using some advanced math and clever tricks, you can actually have zero-knowledge proofs with no back and forth interaction and only one round that still have a really good probability threshold. So, this protocol can be made very cheap. Well, it looks like you can prove two things are different colors. What else can you prove? As it turns out, a lot of stuff. Every single problem in NP has a zero-knowledge proof. You probably don't know what NP is, but let's just say it includes a ton of useful problems like circuit classifiability, the traveling salesman problem, and integer factory. So why care about zero-knowledge proofs? There are tons of applications where you would want to prove something without revealing secret knowledge. 1 million passwords are stolen every week. With zero-knowledge proofs, you can prove to the bank you know the password without ever sending it over the internet. All the bank would have to do is ask you some questions about the password, but those questions don't actually reveal any information about the password, just that you know it. Phishing, the most common cybercrime of 2020, would be eliminated completely. What's more, a zero-knowledge proof password protocol, SRP, already exists. Shame on you, everyone who doesn't use it yet. And in 2016, researchers at Princeton University designed a protocol that could prove an object is not a nuclear weapon without revealing its contents. So clearly, this concept is very useful. For now, it's mostly used by cryptocurrencies, but maybe one day, they will be applied in all kinds of places to protect our security and privacy. Phishing? What's that? Now, the flower example might seem a bit contrived, as it requires a colorblind person and physical flowers. So, I'll describe a real zero-knowledge proof protocol that can be run on computers within a fraction of a second for my more mathematically inclined viewers. You have an integer g, a large prime p, and an integer y. Everyone knows these three numbers. You want to prove that you know a value x such that g to the x mod p equals y, without revealing x. That is, if you multiply g with itself x times, then divide that by p and take the remainder, you get y. For example, let's say g equals 3, p equals 5, and y equals 1. Then you want to prove you know the x that satisfies 3 to the x mod 5 equals 1. Why can't you just calculate x? Well, this is called the discrete logarithm problem. And it turns out, you can't really do much better than just trying every single x to see if it works. So in our example, 3 to the 1 mod 5 equals 3 mod 5, which is 3. 3 squared mod 5 equals 9 mod 5, which is 4. 3 cubed mod 5 equals 27 mod 5, which is 2. And 3 to the 4th mod 5 equals 81 mod 5, equals 1. So x equals 4 is the correct answer. But for large g and p, it could take even modern computers years and years to find x. But if you're the person who chose x equals 4, g equals 3, and p equals 5 in the first place, you can calculate y to be g to the x mod p, which is 3 to the 4th mod 5, which is 1. So then, of course you know x, because you're the one who chose it. But no one else will know x unless they get really, really, really lucky. Okay, so this is all cool, but why do we care about proving we know x? Well, x could be your password. Then if you prove you know x without revealing it, you can log into your bank without sending them your password. So how do you prove you know x without sending it to the verifier? First, you generate a random integer r. Then you calculate c to be g to the r mod p, and send c to the verifier. Now, the verifier can ask you what w equals x plus r mod p minus 1 is. The verifier can check that you know x using c and w. As you know, when you multiply two exponentials, their exponents add. So, y times c mod p equals g to the x times g to the r mod p, which is g to the x plus r mod p, which is g to the x plus r mod p minus 1 mod p, which is g to the w mod p. That last part works because of something called Fermat's little theorem. When you have an exponential mod p, you can apply mod p minus 1 to the exponent. If you provide w to the verifier, they can verify that y times c mod p equals g to the w mod p. If that holds, then you pass the test. Cool, but wait, there's actually a way to cheat. You could have chosen a random z and then calculated c to be g to the z divided by y mod p. For the question of what w is, you send in z. Then you don't actually know what x or r is, but your z and c pass the test. Y times c mod p equals y times g to z divided by y mod p, which is just g to the z mod p. To make sure you actually did choose a random r, the prover would also have to ask you what r was, so they can verify that g to the r mod p equals c. And you didn't just choose a random z that wasn't calculated by adding r to x. And yet, if the prover asks for both x plus r and r, then they now know what x is. Then the protocol is not zero knowledge, since the whole point was to keep x secret.
Mission failed. We'll get them next time.
Don't give up yet. The trick is to not ask for x plus r and r, but to randomly ask for one of the two. If you don't know x, then you can choose to give c equals g to the r mod p, and then you can provide r. Or you can give c equals g to the z divided by y mod p, and provide x plus r as z. But no matter how you prepare, you cannot provide both r and the x plus r. You're caught in a catch-22. If you give c equals g to the r mod p, then you can't answer what x plus r is. If you give c equals g to z divided by y mod p, then you can't answer what r is. If the prover runs for many rounds and randomly asks for either x plus r or r each time, the best you can do is make a random guess which to prepare for, and you only guess correctly with 50% probability. Unless, of course, you actually know x. So here is the full protocol. Just like in the magic flower example, if you know x, you can always answer correctly. But if you don't, then you can only answer correctly with 1/2 probability. And afterwards, the prover has no idea what x is. So there you go, a zero-knowledge proof that you can use to log in without sending your password. Phishing? What's that?